half. Fuck this. Hello. I turned on my air conditioning unit, which is over there. Let me show you guys real quick. You see that unit over there? And it's super loud. Can you let me know if you hear it at all?
It's good?
Cool. Jesus. I hope my stream doesn't end. How long you streaming for, Jimmy? Now, hey, what's up, Saiyans? I'm not sure. 18 hours?
18 hours? Do you have a new guest every hour?
Yeah, no, it's just going to be me. I'm just going to sit here. And I'm going to let you guys watch me for 18 hours. I'm going to stream for like 24 hours one time, just sitting here. Pretending I have a life. And look, can I bring Saiyans in? I think I'm going to bring Saiyans in. And then, whatever. Don't speak over Saiyans, by the way, ASMR. I'm going to have him smash you.
What up?
Hey, Saiyans, what's up?
Nah, I'm just watching this crazy-ass video where this lady yelling at squirrels and shit.
Oh. Hey, okay, go ahead and speak. Billiam's here, Kitty's here, the crazy lady, and then ASMR. Hold on, go ahead.
Yeah, what's up?
Hello.
Hello.
I turned
which
off.
Which one's the one that called me last night?
That was me.
I didn't mean to be rude to you. It's just when I'm drunk, I'm very, very... I like
I know, man.
Move things along.
I know, man. It's no worries. Seriously, like I knew that you were shit faced. I just wanted to call in and say hi because I knew a bunch of the Jimmer Nam crowd was in there, so I thought they'd find it funny to hear a familiar voice.
Yeah, I was on a mission last night to trash someone, so I was staying focused.
I didn't know what was going on, so I just sort of played along, and I was like, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
But it's fine, dude. That was funny.
You got echo in the background, by the way, Billiam.
What'd you say?
You got some echo in the background, Billiam.
Please come again.
Can't find the Jimmer Nam. Can't find the Jimmer Nam.
Of course, that's Shane's song that he sings. Hey, what's going on with you, brother? Saiyans?
None.
Wait, is it Saiyans E or Saiyans?
Just Saiyans.
Yeah. So what's anything new developing at all? That's interesting.
No, I've just been chilling.
Yeah.
Bored day today for me.
How come you're not doing a live stream today?
Yeah, I don't really like doing them on Saturday nights.
Yeah, because you do them every night pretty much too.
Yeah, plus, like, I could have did one, but then probably would have been, like, a drunk one. I was like, I just drank three nights in a row. I don't know if I should go for a fourth night.
Yeah. I understand. But shit, man. I don't know. I guess there's going to be a special somewhere, but no one's going to be watching. So I don't know how special this special is going to be.
Yeah, I saw your tweet on Twitter.
Oh, you did? Okay. I didn't get a message back, though. So, a reply. No.
That dude is such a cornball. Yeah. He completely gave up on calling into my shit.
Broke Bar, as you call him, right? Yeah. What's up with that guy?
For you people don't know, Broke Bar, he's a ripoff of Red Bar. You probably don't know who Red Bar is. Red Bar is some dude who does some show. It's not really that popular. No one really knows who he is. But Broke Bar's setup is the exact setup, but opposite. and he's called Red Bar his hero, and he's been doing this for 5 years and has two people watching him.
Right. Shit, he's been doing YouTube for 5 years?
Well, he used to have to lie and say he worked in regular radio, but if you look into it, him and his friends just started a website and called it like WEMF Radio. It'd be like me starting a website and calling it Sane's TV, then saying I work for a TV channel or something. So, but I mean, it's just that. Like, I went through all his shit. He went like this Reddit post of him trying to meet chicks on Reddit saying, I work at a radio station. Maybe we should hook up.
Oh my God. Billiam, have you ever gone on Reddit to pick up chicks? Is that a place to go pick up chicks? Are you here, Billiam?
That's a bad idea. You shouldn't go to Reddit ASMR to pick guy. Up chicks.
Yeah, ASMR guy would know that for sure. He's a virgin, actually. He's a 31-year-old virgin. Are you a 30-year-old? Yeah. He's he had a threesome, though, he says, but nothing went down. They just kissed.
How are you a virgin if I had a threesome but nothing went down?
Yeah, at least I embraced my virginity.
But well, wait. How'd you have a threesome and you're still a virgin?
Yeah, ASMR.
There was no insertion. Even my friend said that, my friend Raul said that doesn't sound like a threesome.
So were you like just a cuck? You were just sitting there?
No, I wasn't sitting there. I wasn't sitting there.
And what the fuck were you doing?
I was actually doing stuff.
Like?
Touching, like what?
I was touching the vagina. I was touching.
He said their vagina. Was it two chicks?
And I was kissing the blonde chick.
Wait. So there were two chicks?
Yeah. One Asian, one blonde.
One Asian with Down syndrome.
Yeah, so that's what happened. Something, I don't remember what happened, but I think one of us had to go, and then that was the end of the person.
Wow. Well,
did you at least fuck? Well, I guess you didn't fuck the other chick. This is, what were you, like drunk or something?
No, I just had a very tight schedule.
He had a tight schedule.
I don't care if I was an astronaut and I had to make it to the next shuttle mission to the moon. If I'm going for a threesome, nothing's ruining that threesome. What did you have to do? What was part of your tight schedule?
Well, I don't know what I was thinking, but yeah, there it is. That's what happened.
Good luck with this guy.
Like, what was it like? Well, what'd you have to go do to leave a threesome?
I just went to the mall. I was meeting someone else there.
So you turned down a threesome to go to the mall?
I was meeting someone there.
So you left the threesome to go hang out at Spencer's in the food court? What's the matter with you?
Oh my God.
Were these chicks hot? The Asian one has to be hot. Asian chicks are like at least four, no matter what.
No.
No. We saw her Facebook, by the way. No.
And, she's yeah, but if it's a threesome, it doesn't matter. They count together. So if it's like 2 4s, it equals out to an 8.
They're two big chicks, so I would say it would probably be a 10-some. Honestly,
the 2 makes it.
They're big. Look, they're big now. They're big now. They weren't big before.
Yeah, but they're not good. They're not. They're ugly.
I wouldn't say the blonde one is ugly. Come on.
Sorry.
She's just cute. She's cute.
It doesn't matter if it's a threesome. It's a threesome. It's dope. It doesn't matter what they look like.
Okay. There you go.
But you turned it down, though.
But you didn't do it because you had to go fucking hang out at the kiosk at the mall. Who goes to the mall?
He's a mall rat. He says he's a mall rat, so.
I was a mall rat, yes.
Is that still a thing?
Yeah, how old were you during this threesome?
It had to have been during 2009, from 2009 to 2011.
Which is it? 2009, 10, 11. Which?
I really don't know the time stamp on this.
How do you forget?
Like, were you very into drugs during this time?
No, it's just that I'm forgetful.
Oh, boy.
Maybe he did have the threesome and he just forgets it.
No, he didn't. Trust me.
I don't know. Just like, you said either 1942 or 1982. I never heard having to leave a threesome to go hang out at the mall. That's, and you're still a virgin now?
Yeah.
I think. According to Kitty.
I think. Hey, Kitty, can you clarify? Is he a virgin or what? Kitty?
Remember, she's at the New Age place.
Did she go already?
I think she went.
What the fuck?
Yeah, oh, she said she had to go now, I'm pretty sure.
Oh my god, you're crazy, Kitty. You are fucking crazy. You are one crazy bitch. She's crazy. What the fuck?
No, man, she's just trying to protect herself.
You're crazy too. You're stupid. You're the only virgin that turns down a threesome. I've never heard of that.
At least I'm openly crazy.
You had to turn down a threesome. You had to go get something at GameStop. Like, who does that?
Okay, let's not put rumors out there, okay?
Uh-huh.
But you said you had to go hang out at the mall. What's at the mall? I haven't been to the mall in probably like 15 years.
I had a meeting at the mall, okay?
You had a meeting? With who? Yeah.
With someone. I'm not going to say who because I don't really remember.
What?
What are you, Jackie Brown? Who are you meeting at the mall?
Wait.
Why are you leaving a threesome?
He just said he doesn't want to tell who it was, but he doesn't remember who it is. So if you don't remember, how could you tell us in the first place
because
who it is?
Even if I do remember, it's probably not something I want to say.
You are.
It was 10 years ago. Who cares?
A meeting? What kind of meeting is that?
The cops might care, but whatever.
A meeting.
Let me assure you, the cops are not going to hear it. They're not listening to us.
No one's listening. Boy, a meeting? A mall meeting? What is this?
I wanted to meet at a public place.
Someone said a Pokemon meeting.
No. Wanted to meet. By the way, I don't like Pokemon Go. I never did.
Dude, just stay with the answer. Go ahead. Stick with your answer. Go. Explain.
Pokemon Go.
Yeah, I never liked that. It's a fad. Anyway, what I was doing was I was meeting someone.
Bullshit.
Who are you selling? Some of the reefer? Pushing some eight? What are you doing?
This story's going to go nowhere. This is what happens all the time.
You're goddamn right. So, yeah. I'm kidding. What happened?
Can you stop fucking with your mic ASMR?
I needed to meet someone. It was a meeting, and I needed to meet this person because if I didn't, then it wouldn't. I don't want to say, okay?
What? Would you have to, like, meet your bookie or something?
Something like that.
Wait. What was the meeting about?
Something like that.
Something like that. That is so
dumb.
What
is this, fucking Brooklyn in 1977? What, you owed the shark some money and you had to pay up?
Well, I definitely did owe money.
Oh. I still don't know what you're talking about.
So you had to leave a threesome to go to the mall.
Someplace public.
Because you know the mafia meets at the mall. So. That's the place to go.
I can just picture De Niro strangling him like he did Maury. Like, where's my fucking money?
Yeah. Right in front of the Gap. Yeah, you were in front of the Gap, weren't you? ASMR. Gap. Meet me in front of the Gap at 5 o'clock.
That was Macy's.
Macy's. Sears.
Yeah, Macy's. Well, someone Sears. Did work there that I know, but that wasn't
not...
Macy's.
Okay. Wow. You're
Why
such
would
bullshit.
You bring up someone works there, you know?
Oh, another story.
The Please story is very odd.
Love the show and everybody here is hilarious.
All right, Luis Gomez. Thank you. Appreciate that. But glad to have Saiyans on. I have your picture up, by the way. It's behind me. That's all right.
Cool.
Dude, so are you done with the guys?
Oh. 10.
10. 10? What is 10? And thanks, Andrew Morgan. Saiyans, so are you done with all that shit over there? I mean, those guys who keep on... Didn't they get rid of your channel and shit? Or they fucking try to fucking do something to your channel?
Bro tried, but the community guideline strikes he did were overturned. But then Anthony Cumia hit me with his own, but...
We are having a reunion this year.
So does Anthony Cumia hate you?
Brian, you pinch too many girls.
He hates me with a passion. In fact, I just found out today that I'm banned from his video game streaming channel.
On Twitch?
No, on YouTube. He has his own personal channel on YouTube. He just streams video games with.
Does he talk and shit?
But he banned you personally already?
Yeah, you know, if you want to ban a YouTube channel, you have to. They've said so on Twitter. They watch everything I do. They were tweeting Lyndon Miller about me in a private message, trying to come up with some bullshit why they disinvited me from their show. Oh, he hates me with a passion.
What does Artie think about this?
Artie is probably doesn't know. He's completely has no idea about any of this.
Oh.
He's just collecting a paycheck, man. You know?
Artie doesn't know anything about anything.
That's so fucked up. They invited Saiyans to go to Compound Media. And then Saiyans raises money to go get, you know, like, he has to go from Rhode Island to New York or something like that. Is that 3 or 4 hours away on a train?
Hour and a half, 2 hours.
Right. And then
each way.
And then he raised the money and then the guy like cancels on him. Anthony Cumia is like, fuck it. You're not coming.
He's going to come face.
That's fucked up, huh? It's like Howard saying, yeah, sure. Come to the studio, Billiam. And then he bans you. He says, fuck you. Wow. You know, when you bought all your tickets.
They did it in some sneaky way because my dumbass went on Twitter and announced it. And since I bypassed anyone at the time, Anthony Cumia was following me on Twitter. So one day I just hit him a direct message and said, can I come to the show? He said, sure.
Him to die or
and then I went on
camp.
Twitter and announced I raised money for it. And I announced the day I would be going. Days before I was going, they hit me with a false copyright strike and a video of me talking about something. And then they started all this shit just to disinvite me.
Wow.
So they didn't even have the balls to come out and just say, you know what? When you asked Anthony, he was shit-faced drunk, and he just said yes when he shouldn't have said yes. So they had to concoct this whole fucking grand conspiracy not to let me go. And then they started with the community guidelines strikes and everything else since. So, yeah, Anthony hates me.
That is so fucking strange, man. That is such a pussy move, man, to do that.
I know, and Anthony claims to be, you know, before the start of the AA show, they have a banner playing that says, Compound Media, the home of free speech. It's the most laughable thing. Hypocrite. Especially, there's a guy who worked there named Kevin Brennan. He said on air, they put it in people's contracts, they're not allowed to talk about other people. It's all bullshit with that, dude.
Yeah. I don't know why do they have so much hate or animosity towards you? I mean, aren't you fucking promoting their shit on your channels anyhow and making them relative still? I mean, it's like free promotion.
Yeah, but if you asked every single one of them, I bet you every single one of them would say that YouTube guy Saiyans, fuck him. All he does is make hate videos about me. So, like, if you asked Opie would say that. Same thing with Opie. Opie has me blocked from all his shit, too. Anthony would say that. Probably the other dude. I mean, but some of them like me. I mean, like, the Mad Cuban likes me. Luis J. Gomez likes me. I don't know where I'm at with Sam Roberts yet.
Well, they know you because I heard Sam Roberts, he actually spoke about you a little bit here and there, right? He mentioned you.
I posted the clip on my channel of, and it's them on video of them talking about me on the Jim and Sam show, because Bob Kelly brought me up. And then, of course, they all know who, because he didn't call me by my name. He said, I can't wait for that guy on YouTube to start talking about this. And then they went for like 40 seconds talking about my videos and shit.
People still busting your balls about Saiyans takes a leak on air. they just donated money to that cause.
Legendary night. Broke Bar's most famous video, by the way.
I know, I saw that, and he almost got 1,000 views. Congratulations, you idiot.
I know.
Off a video.
Like, I could copyright take it down anytime I want, but I'm a nice
I'll
guy.
I'll pay the rest when it's confirmed it wasn't
like
her.
That. So he should have took that as a sign of my generosity, but like I said, he sort of thought he'd give up with me because, I don't know, as people can attest when you call into me, I'm not that nice of a guy, but... So I guess he decided to move on to you.
Billiam said he could attest it.
Hey, I think that's why he tried moving on to you.
You let me host your show for a whole minute, so that was fun.
And you did horribly. You didn't know what to do. You're like,
I didn't know what to do, so I just rambled.
I know.
Did you? Oh, and wait, did I get mad at you when I came back? Was I mad at you before or after? I think now it's starting to come back to me.
I think it was both.
I know, because I think I came downstairs and I thought I caught you trying to get off the phone.
Well, I didn't know what to say. I'd run out of things to say.
You didn't even say anything. You're like,
I should have started singing like, hello, my baby. Hello, my honey. Hello,
oh, you would have gotten smashed if you did that. They would have. Yeah, that would have been bad.
I need to take a piss and probably grab some more liquor. So I usually wait till someone calls in, and maybe that piss video of me is no one called in at that time. My biggest fear, because obviously I blacked out during that video. When I, you know, the worst thing happens when you wake up the next morning and you were live streaming the night before and you don't know what the fuck you did, and then you hear you pissed.
Yeah.
The only thing I was like, tell me I did not take my dick out on camera.
Oh boy. Yeah, no, that didn't happen.
Wait, did you take your dick out on camera?
No.
No, I was aware enough to move to the side. I only cared because I just didn't fucking I would have been completely banned from YouTube forever if that happened.
But you deleted it anyhow.
that would have been like a lifetime ban. They're like, did that fucking guy take his dick out on camera?
Dude, what if you pissed on your cam and shit? That would have been great. But no, none of that should happen. Who cares, though? Fuck it. You drank and you pissed. Fuck. Who gives a shit?
He performed two bodily functions, normal functions.
But me too, dude. As a YouTuber, because we hop on a lot, so we don't know sometimes if it's off or on. Sometimes I get paranoid. I'm like, oh shit, did I do something? So I gotta watch the replay.
I always call Jimmer and he's peeing, always.
Yeah, that's true. So, fuck you. But no, but seriously, I don't know sometimes if I hit the stop stream or not. You know, who knows? Like, there's been people jerking off, like gamers who forgot to turn off their cam and they're jerking off to porn. And then they were caught on live stream.
What?
Yeah. I swear to God, there's this guy on Twitch or something. He got caught jerking off. He thought he ended his stream, but he didn't. And then he turned his porn on. So he was looking at the camera, like the monitor where his webcam was. And he was fucking jerking it. And then, And then he was going to go right back to his gaming stream. He's like, oh, wait. Oh, my God. I'm still on?
Or maybe he knew he was on.
And that shit went viral.
Play, you know, safe. You know,
no, he like, didn't know.
That's like, his kink.
Wow, you're stupid, ASMR, if you thought that was for real. No, it was not for real. It was, didn't, he thought he turned off his stream, but he didn't.
Come on, no. Come on.
Okay, whatever. Stupid. It ruined his fucking streaming career, by the way.
The worst feeling ever.
Please come again.
Like when I do a junk Science live stream and I wake up the next morning and I'm like, fuck, what did I say and do last night? Terrible feeling.
Yeah. Fuck, man. So, are you done with them, or are you going to keep on battling over there?
Depends if I got some, like, yesterday. I just had nothing to talk about. You know, I didn't make that many videos today either. Really nothing to talk about. I got mad shit since, you know, old Trampa got his license back tonight. Oh, I got plenty to talk about tomorrow, so probably not tomorrow.
Well, they're over there talking shit about us, by the way. I'm just getting some news right here. So I guess he went live to his two people or three people, or however many people there are. But whenever he talks about you or me, when he was talking about you, he would get viewers, right? Just because people are interested in what he's saying about you. But then when he stops talking and does his own shit, like he talks about Unsolicited or WEMPF, whatever radio, like there's
like
nobody in there.
Unsolicited, like that shitty show from the other network?
No. I don't know if it's Unsolicited. I don't know what they talk about, honestly.
Social conditioning.
Conditioning. Okay. Like, no one gives a fuck. They leave. Like, then he's left with two people or one, maybe three, if he's lucky. And last night was funny. He was going on live, like, all night again, like, sporadically. Yeah. And he had no views for the entire evening. No views on all, like, three or four videos he uploaded until the morning.
Even during, what do you do, a 12-hour stream? And he got, what, like, 500 views? I was trying to tell people, just by random people accidentally clicking on your shit because it's live over the course of 12 hours, you should get at least 800 views.
Or 1,000 at least. 12 hours?
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, 12 hours and you only got 500 views? Holy shit. But,
like, you don't want a dude who, he's literally been doing this for years, and he just doesn't know how to do it. He's one of these guys. He thinks he's funny, he thinks he's interesting, and hasn't realized he's not. And if he was, he would have more than fucking two subscribers.
Yeah.
By the way, Shuli, the so-called comedian, is live on Twitch.
Shuli? How many people does he have? I bet he has like 10 or 20.
Why don't you go take a look?
I don't want to go take a look at that shit. I hate Shuli. Fuck him. Piece of shit.
That's a snore.
That guy fucking blocked me on Twitter for no reason, Shuli. He hates me.
Because they all know. It's like the same people, like Opie and Anthony, and then they all know. They hate it, but they probably sort of like it that people are now making videos about them, but...
Yeah. Because not many people do, right? I mean, honestly...
Well, no one did.
Are people doing it for Opie and Anthony like you do it, or like no. Are there other YouTubers or no?
No, I'm the only one really doing it.
And dude, yesterday and another night, I was trying to explain to people like what you do and what I do. Like people are saying, would we ever get into a fight? Like, I don't think so, because like, I think we kind of respect one like each other's work, because like I talked about you using your phone in the beginning, right? And people were giving a lot of shit. Oh, he's using his Cricket wireless phone. But dude, I tried using my phone to do streaming and it's fucking hard. Like, especially if you mess up and you're doing like a short little news clip that's maybe 3 or 4 minutes, it's not that easy. You know, it's not as easy as just turning it on and doing shit. And then you're doing it like a few times during the day. It's actually like you put in work in that, you know? There's a lot of like, I don't know. It's not easy, let's just say. It's work.
Well, yeah, like, one of Brokebar's complaints about me is that he'll go, your audio stinks, and before I even got to, like, oh, he doesn't even have a laptop. I was like, I don't need it. See, for people like that, they think if they build, like, a studio or something, that makes them good. Doesn't matter where you're doing your shit from. It matters what you're saying, not where you're saying it from.
Yeah. Yeah. And Billion was saying, we know all about that because look at Gonzo podcast. Okay, they're starting to look a little better and sound a little better, thanks to me, because I helped them, and they're supposed to pay me 10 G's, by the way, which I never got, which improved their audio and their fucking video. But anyhow, so that stuff looks good. It's looking better, but their content sucks. No one's watching them. And you've already pointed out on your YouTube channel about them buying fucking fake subs. It's so obvious. I mean, like,
what do you think their goal is? Because they put a lot of money into what they're doing and not have seen 1 cent back in any return. What do you think their ultimate goal is?
Fuck, I don't even know, man. I mean, the guy who runs it.
Do you think that I'm thinking they're trying to buy their way to having enough numbers to where they can approach?
That's what they're doing.
Celebrity, and yep. You know, someone who doesn't know shit about anything, they'll just see a channel that has 100,000 subscribers and go, "Hey, right, they want to interview you." I think it maybe that's their goal.
No, you're right on the money, bro. You got it. You nailed it. I'm not seeing
a point in spending that much money, and it's obvious. Like when I first clicked on them, what they had 5,000 subscribers and 2,000 views, I was like, all right, that makes no sense.
Makes zero.
But even now, like, because now they smartened up and figured out they got to start putting views, not just subscribers, but they're doing it in a row. So, like, their first 20 videos will have 10,000 views, and then right after it will have 10 views and 15 views.
Yeah, it's so very fucking bizarre. No, it's clear. It's so clear. I mean, look at all their analytics. They bought a lot of subs. They bought pretty much all their subs. I don't even think they have like even 100 real subs, to be honest with you. When they first started, it was like maybe 20, and that was all their staff members, so-called on-air talent, you know? And that was it. And then it all of a sudden jumped to 1,000, to 5,000, 10,000, to 12,000. And then what happened is it dropped because the fake subs, they kind of like drop off like flies. So they went from like 12,000 something to 10,000, I think they're at right now. But you're right, dude, about the whole thing. Like, they do the same shit on Periscope. They buy super hearts. They buy hearts in general, because you need about 180,000 super hearts to monetize on Periscope, which is hard to get. And they do the same shit over there. And I don't know. You're right about their end goal is like they brought in Mary Carey, that porn star. They brought in Honey Boo Boo's sister or some shit that nobody cares about. And then they brought in Andy Dick. And they're trying to bring in all these Howard Stern whack packers. And they pretend.
So I assume their pitch to these guys would be, is like, look, we have a YouTube channel with thousands of subscribers. And these people, let's keep it real, Andy Dick, he doesn't fucking know what Datus is. Probably knows nothing about how analytics work and that it's all bullshit.
Yeah.
I mean, I hope for them it pays off, because by my estimates, they've probably put in $30,000 into their channel and probably
easily
haven't received a cent back. And that's easily, just from what I've seen. I don't even know how long they've been trying to do this.
They've been doing it the same, probably about five months. Yeah, four or five months.
Good jobs to be, you know.
No, the guy's a felon.
Money into this.
No, the guy's a felon. His name's Jeff Henson. He's a fucking. He has 42 felony charges, and they're all about internet fraud and scam. And so that's where he gets his money. He owes about almost $500,000 in judgments right now, and he's got a $4.2 million lawsuit currently that he's facing. That his wife is going to be served this week. Ruth Ann Henson's going to be served with something, a cease and desist, I don't know, whatever. But because the house is under her name, because this guy's such a criminal that he put his name under her, the house under her name. And now the wife is fucked. That house belongs to the people he doxed and the people he fucked over. So that's where he's funding the money. Or that's where the money's coming from fraud and scam.
Wife must be related to Jim Henson or some shit. Niggas are blowing mad loot.
Yeah, seriously. But no, I mean, she's just a fucking nurse. And again, who gives a shit about them? They suck anyhow. No one's watching them. And they do the same shit on Periscope. They get thousands and thousands of views, right? But if you look at their hearts count, it's like less than mine in one broadcast. Yeah. It doesn't make sense. And I only get like a couple hundred, maybe, if that. But I get more hearts than them in when they get thousands of views on one broadcast. It just doesn't make any. Nothing makes sense with them. It's all bullshit. So
I just couldn't imagine spending, like, I don't understand this. Them and Brokebar, this just willing to do this but have no results. I don't get that.
Well, they're not making any money, right? You need to remember YouTube just changed policy, and you know, right? So the whole thousand
channels is about to get probably tomorrow, because I just got to hit the 4,000 watch time hours. I should hit that by tomorrow, but.
And you probably hit it easy.
What the fuck they're doing?
You probably hit it easy, though, because I get 4,000 pretty quickly. Like when I started my new channels, because I got my first one fucked up by SiriusXM, and I had one on a ban from fucking Gonzo, which I got overturned, by the way. It took them months to fucking overturn my copyright strike, or the copyright strike I got against Gonzo Podcast, a false fucking copyright strike. And they sided with me. So stupid.
Well, that's why I'm still trying to hold out hope for my main channel. As you know, I've had two channels that got taken down. The last one, I got the decision real quick back on that. That ain't coming back. But my original one, the one with over 3,000 subs, I still haven't heard any shit on the review.
They haven't responded. Dude, YouTube's really slow on responding and monetizing too. Like, I've had two of my channels right now in pending mode for over 2 months or 3 months now.
I know, on that last channel, I hit the goal, and I was pending too. Back when I started July 4th, all you needed was the 10,000 views, and the second you hit it, the second you sent in, I hit your little thing right away.
Enable,
you just turned it on.
Yeah, now it's like, but a lot of YouTubers are having problems, because I've seen different YouTube threads, content providers, and they have the same issues with us. They have a lot of waiting about the disputes of community guideline strikes or copyright strikes. They take forever to answer now. And then also monetizing new channels again. They're taking forever. I'm telling you, like, this channel that I'm streaming on, it's still, I have over 9,000 or 10,000 hours right now, and it's still not monetized. It's still impending. And I've reached out to them, and they just gave me a fucking fake thing, like, oh, we're really busy right now, please be patient, we're, you know, overload on all this shit. It's like, what the fuck, man? YouTube is like broken.
Yeah, I was over at my boy's house the other day. He was showing me how to run programs and shit. He was giving me the whole, you need to get your ass to Twitch speech. I don't know. And I just watched, you probably don't know this guy, is Tommy Sotomayor, some black crazy guy that I like following, who keeps getting kicked off of YouTube. He just was like, yo, Twitch is the new spot to be.
Really?
Kind of starting to sell me on it.
I heard it's hard to make monetize over there for some reason. It's not as easy as YouTube.
Well, the way my boy broke it down for me, he said, if you can get 80 people and a consistent watching you for like a week, you'll become a partner and get. But the way, like, he doesn't have that. The way he'd be getting money off of it, he said, is this, it's weird to explain. It's this bit sharing thing. Apparently, you can collect bits from watching ads, and every bit is worth a penny, but anyone can just throw bits at you. Like, he got like $100 just off of the shit for this month.
Wow. I don't know too much about Twitch. I just heard it's really difficult.
You kept trying to sell me on it. The most attractive thing about his pitch was, he said, there's no community guideline strikes. There's no fucking copyright shit. Like, there is, but he's like, they don't fucking
pay
attention
to any of
that shit.
Well, you know how a lot of people make money on Twitch is they have it so that you subscribe, so that you have to have people subscribe, and then they get, like, special emojis and shit like that, and it's like their version of Super Chat, but it's like $5 a month.
Yeah. Oh. That's another way you can do it too.
But then you don't get like the exposure like YouTube, huh? Like, dude, YouTube.
No.
That's like, a platform.
Like, my boy just he'd started on Twitch and never went anywhere else, so he's. And like he's just hitting a minimum of $100 now, and he's been putting in mad work on it. But he made a good point to me of, because I had the same thing. I was like, I'm gonna ask everyone who follows me to go to fucking Twitch. I gotta start at Twitch. I got this thing on YouTube. And he was like, yeah, but all you do is YouTube. He said, yeah. If all you did was Twitch, you'd be able to do it over there. But
yeah, and are you doing both though? Can you can restream on? I haven't done Twitch.
I do both, but he said there's a difference. Like, if all your people can do is find you on Twitch, they'll go to Twitch. If you're doing both, they'll just keep watching you on YouTube.
That is true, though. But then, like, all of them.
He told me to, like, because you know how I do, like, my quick 3-minute videos?
Yeah.
He said, just like every night, just throw one last video up and say, hey, you want to watch the live stream? You got to go to Twitch or something.
Yeah,
I don't know if I'm completely sold on it, but I'm finding it more and more interesting.
I think yeah, that's a great idea to like put like a little short promo on YouTube to go, hey, I'm going live tonight, and then I'll be on Twitch, and they'll probably follow you, you know. But yeah, because YouTube's just lagging with the whole fucking monetization. I don't know what the fuck their issue is nowadays. It's not easy anymore. I don't know what the fuck they're doing, honestly.
Plus, it's too easy to strike people. Like, another reason why it took me like a week to hit the 4,000 watch hours, I have to delete all my fucking live streams.
Yeah.
You gotta go. They're all up at Twitch. I don't have to worry about any of them at Twitch, so. But I have to delete them off of YouTube.
Yeah, I mean, you can do like. Literally a 4-hour to 10-hour stream, and everything's perfect except one part. You know, you said fuck or something, and bam, community guideline strikes, and then they penalize you. You know, right away, without even putting in an appeal. It's like you're fucked.
In 3 months, you can't live 90 days. For 3 months.
Yeah, that's why two of my channels right now are locked up. I have 4 channels because of this bullshit, and then because all I do is live stream, and it's like I get one little smack on the fucking wrist and I'm done, and I got to go switch over to some other fucking piece of shit channel, and it's like, you know how headache, that's a headache, and that's fucking bullshit.
So that's why I had to switch to the Patreon thing and just set a goal, and I told the people, look, if you can hit this goal, I'll keep going, because after the second count got taken out, I was like, yo, there's no point in keep doing this. If I gotta keep shutting down to make an account, so I put a goal on Patreon and I hit the goal, so I'm willing to keep doing it. But I can never imagine like not making a dime and putting up with this bullshit.
Dude, how long did it take you to start making some money on advertising on YouTube? Because it took me a long time. Month. Well, like I did too, but it was very small. Like, dude, I was making like. Less than $15 a month, like in the very beginning. And then I think the 8th month for me, or the 7th, somewhere in 6 to 8 months, then I started making, I think, I want to say $90. And you need to hit 100 to get paid, right? But
month I hit the 100. And I started just right in the beginning of the adpocalypse. But that's the only thing that kept me making videos, because I didn't think you could make money from doing this. I just did everything normal. Then I went and checked that AdSense thing, and I was like, oh? So, I just basically, like, if I get monetized again, because that's where I was making the money. I shouldn't have to. Have a Patreon and ask people for money.
Why not?
YouTube
you do
should
work.
Just pay me.
You well, do work though.
Because I shouldn't have to.
You shouldn't have to, but still. Yeah.
Yeah, but I like getting it from the ad revenue.
All right, but you can get it from both.
I like the fact that I earned it and that I don't have to rely on people giving it to me.
But I think they want to, too, because they appreciate what you do, you know? And
well, yeah, but in that case, I'd rather keep it to a super chat situation.
Yeah. But let's be honest. It's not like YouTube's paying us a ton of money. They're fucking pocketing most of the money. And then they give us what chump change, pretty much. I mean, yeah, we have to go work our ass off to get views and watch time. Because right now, views doesn't mean shit. It's like watch time, you know? So that's really important now.
Jimmer Nam, I was making a ton of money.
You were? Fucking A, man.
Let's just say I have.
Sign me up.
When they sent me my W-2s, I have to fucking pay the government now.
Oh, well, here's the situation, though. Because it took me a little bit longer than you to pop. And I popped in about December, right? But I started 11 months ago. And you started in July, right? So I started a little bit before you, a few months before you. And it took me a while to pop. I don't know why. Just maybe because I'm doing Howard Stern shit at the time, and I don't know. I really don't. But it took me a while to pop, so I started popping in December, and so I went from like $90 in November to about 100 something, almost $200 in December, and then it jumped to like 500 in January.
Yeah.
And then my channel got deleted, or you know, fucked by Sirius, and then it's starting over. So all those 11, like it went from $100 or $90 to literally $500 in 2 months in ad revenue. So I saw it growing because all the 11 months of work I did, but then I had to delete all that fucking shit because I got copyright, and now it's like starting all over again. So it sucks. Like how you did it, it just grows exponentially, right? Like the next month it's boom, just like.
Yes. And like, I guess maybe because the Opie and Anthony fans are more rabid. And, like, since, let's be honest, SiriusXM can't touch Opie and Anthony shit on YouTube, I had more engagement. And I was doing, like, fucking 7 videos a day, each hitting, like, 2,000 per video. That's how.
Oh shit! Your thing's going in and out.
Live streaming until December.
Oh, you started live streaming in December?
Yeah, I believe that was the first time I ever did it.
Yeah.
I'm still trying. Why? Because I was banned from it for 3 months.
Oh shit!
I remember now. Yeah, because I played a video, O&A video, but I did it from Vimeo. Not from YouTube, not realizing, oh, there's a reason why you put him on Vimeo and not YouTube.
Oh, because it's copywritten.
When was your first drunk stream?
Yeah, that's a good idea, by the way.
Probably like my third stream in. the streaming thing I didn't think was, I thought I'd just give it a try, to be honest. I was more excited that I was able to do it again.
Dude, doesn't YouTube fuck you over if you put drunk stream? Don't they poo-poo on all these bad words like drunk stream or murder or kill or all these well, are certain keywords.
Doing it on the main channel, it would get yellow badged no matter what, but I didn't care because it was like just a cap. I was making my money from my regular videos and I would get super chats and shit, so I didn't care.
Yeah. Hey, what happened to your Periscope? Did you get deleted?
The new one. I don't know. I guess it's gone.
Did they send you anything? Like, we're going to delete your channel?
Nah, like, something. I got hit with. I turned it on. It said DMCA thing. And I was like, okay, whatever.
Copyright?
It worked, but it would no longer connect to my Twitter.
Oh.
And then, since I signed up for Periscope with that Twitter, I couldn't make another Periscope and connect it to my Twitter. So fucking weird.
Yeah, you have to make a new Twitter account to set up another Periscope.
Yeah, and I tried doing that in the NACA band. So.
Okay. For DMCA, so the copyright shit, they banned you for that?
Yeah, I don't... It had to have been, because, you know, I'll play a song at the beginning.
Dude, that's weird because like, Periscope.
Usually YouTube just hits me with that, you know, don't worry, heads up.
Yeah, I get that too. And they, you can't monetize it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Although I noticed, they got that feature where you can just mute that shit now.
Right. Yeah. Shit, man. Wow, Periscope fucking banned or got rid of your channel? Damn. I'm trying to get rid of Periscope and they won't ban me.
I don't
know. I guess I'll have to do something.
I tried to deactivate the account, but I guess that's a whole process because every time you try and like go start a new one, it just goes, your account has been restored. So it's such bullshit.
Wow. You know, that's strange. It's fucking strange, man. Are you going to be live streaming tomorrow?
I believe it's tomorrow, Easter.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sunday. Yeah. Easter. Yeah. Fuck, yeah, man.
Probably be drunk too. Get smashed on.
Oh, hold on. You want to take this call? Let's see. I think it's Kenny. Is this Kenny? Kenny? Yeah, it is Kenny because he doesn't respond real quickly. Give him a like second here. Kenny. Yeah. Fucking hello? Kenny. Yeah. Fuck, man.
Hey, Jimmer, what's happening, man?
Yeah. What's up?
How should I go?
What?
My night television.
My night is fine, Kenny. How's your night?
What?
How is your night, Kenny? Are you having
it? I saw Gilbert Godfrey.
Oh, okay. Well, congratulations. Where did you see him?
I saw him at Yonkers Comedy Club in a mall.
All right. All right, Kenny. Thank you for calling. Do you have a question for CNs?
I think he's a good show.
All right.
All you people in the mall? I haven't been to the mall in that long. What the fuck am I missing at the mall?
Everything. Well, Gilbert Godfrey.
No, Dave, you're missing nothing. The mall is the most boring piece of shit place ever.
It's probably dead. No one goes to the fucking mall.
It's not that bad. I saw one of my good friends there.
All right, Kenny. You know, okay.
That's what I always hated about going to the mall. You always run into somebody.
I didn't mind running into him. He's a good friend.
Hey, do you have a question for Saiyans or not, Kenny? Fucking kidding.
Why doesn't he take more than one call at a time?
Who?
Him. I tried to call in there. I couldn't get through.
Okay. So, Saiyans, what?
I can only
what?
Take one call at a time.
Why don't you have Skype or something? Skype. And you can take more than one call.
I do. I just haven't set it up because I'm like computer illiterate. So, and I can do it like through Discord. And the second I can ever figure that out.
Oh, dude, use Discord like I am.
Well, I got the Discord and thing.
Dude, it's the best.
Give it a try.
You can add as many people as you want. And if you actually create like a Saiyans channel, like I'll try to help you with that. Actually, you can create your own sort of like community. We have like almost 80 people now in there, and it's
offline.
Yeah, you talk like 24/7 chat, and you can go into voice, and you can pull in people from on air to call waiting to live on air, like how I do. And you can literally bring in as many people as you want. You can bring in 300 people if you wanted. And you don't have to use the phone lines. They could just come in.
We could all be part of Saiyans Entertainment. It would be awesome.
Yeah.
I got a Discord. It's called Saiyans.
You do have a community. Okay.
If you don't like looking at horrible things, don't go there.
Oh, we do.
I just made it and I tweeted out, here's my Discord. Oh, boy.
You're a funny dude.
Yeah, then that way you can bring in whoever the fuck you want from your community, and then you could take calls, I guess. I mean, Kenny, maybe he doesn't want to pick up on you. I don't know. Maybe he probably has caller ID, and he's like, oh, shit, is that Kenny guy? I don't know. Fuck.
He doesn't even know who I am.
Yeah, he does. No, he doesn't. Hey, you know, Kenny, can we talk about your, you said you fucked 5 dudes or 10 dudes? which was now five guys. So he went to a gay bar and he fucked five dudes in the bathroom in the stall. But he said that doesn't make him gay because I guess you have to fuck 10 guys. What is the minimum amount of guys you have to fuck before you're considered gay, Kenny?
I don't know.
What's the magic number? According to you.
I have no idea.
Okay. But you're not gay because you only fucked five guys, so you're in the very low numbers of fucking dudes in the ass. Correct?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Oh, I know.
Now I want a five guys burger.
You're already gay because you fucked one guy.
Dude, five guys is amazing.
All right. Well, Kenny,
I'm hungry for five guys burgers and fries now.
Yeah, me too. Do you like five guys, Kenny?
Not for gay sex with five guys, but the food.
Oh, okay. Oh, I didn't know that.
I hate Five Guys burgers.
Oh, you do? But you like Five Guys, though. Kenny, can you turn off that shit in the back?
The problem is you do like Five Guys burgers a little too much.
Mm-hmm.
Five Guys burgers fucking rules. Everything else there sucks, but their burgers are good.
Their
burgers are good, but it's like $15. You can go get a better burger and better fries at a diner for the same amount.
Kenny, you have like echo in the back.
Well, yeah, everyone's burgers are like $15, but their burgers are great.
It's true.
Their fries suck.
Hey, but Kenny,
Well, I agree with you on that. The fries do suck.
Kenny, Sands knows about trannies because he actually is close with Anthony Cumia. I don't know what... Did he fuck a tranny or something, Anthony Cumia? What would happen over there?
It was one of the greatest blockbuster stories that happened. Now, Anthony Cumia, you know, is a... He's a guinea. He's a wop. He fancies himself one of the good fellas. Straight Republican gun owner.
Kenny, I tried to call you.
Jesus, why don't you just interrupt, Kitty, at will?
When did you try and call me?
Oh, these two lovers. All right, go ahead, Zanes.
Yeah, Kenny, I tried to call you and you didn't pick up.
Jesus Christ.
When was this?
About 20 minutes ago.
So what, are you upset that your boyfriend didn't call you?
I was getting worried because you didn't do your show tonight.
Thank God.
Well, I sent a thing on Twitter saying I wouldn't be around. If I have something better to do, I won't do a show.
What?
Okay.
You're a fucking asshole, dude. If you have something better to do, what are you possibly doing? Because you had a tranny come over, he had this black tranny come over and fuck him in the ass. He paid, what, $30? What did you pay?
Giggity.
To a hotel? How much money did you pay, Kenny?
$60.
Because he wanted to feel a cock in his ass. So he paid $60 in this black tranny. Kenny has an interesting life. Jesus. I like Kenny. I mean, he's got an interesting life. I mean, that's for sure.
Gilbert Gottfried. That was...
Nah, that's not interesting. That's actually boring. So, no one wants to hear that story.
Actually, I do.
All right. Well, so, what do you want to tell us about Gilbert Gottfried, Kenny?
He was really funny and...
He was funny at the mall?
Did he squint a lot and yell?
Yeah.
Not really. He smiled a lot.
Did you fuck him?
He's in a good place in his life with his wife and kids.
Did you get turned on at all, Kenny?
No.
Wow, Kenny, that's a great story. Thanks for sharing.
Kenny sucks.
Kenny? He's just on a delay.
A lot of people said, but I don't care what their opinions are, nor yours.
That's true, Ken. Hey, Ken, when are you going to do your show, by the way? Do you have the webcam?
I have not gotten the camera yet. The minute I get the camera, it should be by Friday.
So next week. So are we doing a Friday show or a Saturday show for you?
I'd say Friday at 10. I'll go on before you come on. You come on at what, 11?
Okay, so what is it, 10? So 10 Eastern Standard Time? So 7 here?
I say so, yes.
Okay, so 7
where
here.
You are.
And then you're doing an hour And you have a co-host? Troy?
Troy Smith.
That's 100% sure?
Yeah.
Because I'm going to do some artwork. I'm going to ask Paul or somebody to do artwork for your stupid show. Okay, I mean, your good show.
I'm going to ask people trivia questions. Rock trivia, trivia about your show, and trivia about Stern, of course.
Okay, don't be playing any copyright music, okay?
No, can't I won't do that. Play any music. I'll just ask questions about bands and stuff like that. I won't be playing any music.
All right, Ken. Are you going to be fucking anybody? Like dudes?
No.
On your show? No? Do you think you
anybody
could ever...
Anybody wants to ask me a question will be forced to deal with Fred's board.
If we send you a dildo, would you suck on it? On cam?
No.
No? Would you stick it in your asshole?
No.
Oh, come on.
If Kitty wanted me to, I could stick it in her asshole.
Okay, I like that too. Kitty, will you go over... Kitty, will you go over Kenny's house and have him stick that in your anus? Anal regions?
I'm not into that.
Yeah, you are.
No, I'm not.
Then I wouldn't do it. I would only want to do things you're into.
Oh, God.
Maybe I'll start with a finger.
Gross.
I don't like my butt being messed with.
Yeah, right. That's not
Jimmer, not everyone.
Finger in there.
Not everyone's into that, Jimmer.
Look at your profile picture.
I mean, you
got
can
a
put
butthole.
A finger in mine that I put a finger in yours.
What? What'd you say, Kenny? You want a finger in your ass?
She can put a finger in mine, I put a finger in hers.
Would you allow her to fuck you with the dildo on? Because she's interested in doing that.
No.
Come on.
No.
Come on, Kenny. You know you
I'm
want it.
I'm not running a limo driver. No thanks.
Oh, bullshit. You had a tranny come over that one time at your hotel, and you were fine, and he
that was
stuck
quite
his
a long time ago.
Yeah, but he stuck his entire 13-inch cock right up your a-hole. Kenny.
I remember hearing, I'll never talk about this again. I believe that for about 5 seconds.
All right.
There's nothing wrong with it.
All right, Kenny. Well, we're looking forward to your show, okay? 7 p.m. on Fridays. I mean, 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, right?
No, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Oh, 10 p.m. Eastern. Okay. All right. Well, I'll confirm with you again this week. Do you have any other questions for Sands? Besides the brilliant question he had earlier?
Is he ever going to get a co-host?
Am I ever going to get a co-host? I don't know. Now...
You can take Kenny.
It's a double-edged sword. With a co-host, you can move a show along. However, if you get a co-host, you pretty much ignore the people in the chat. So,
I would not ignore the people in the chat if I had a co-host. I will soon. I would read the comments, talk to
please
the
come again.
At the same time.
Jimmer, Kenny is the reason
they
I listen.
The
he is fucking it awesome.
Yeah. I'm probably not going to have a co-host.
Yeah, that's not his thing, I guess.
It's also hard to find someone who wants to actually, you know, put themselves out there to do a show.
I wish Tara could be in here, because I know Saiyans likes Tara. Where's
like
Tara?
That.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Saiyans, do you want Kenny? You could take him. I'll give it to you.
I'm all set.
I'll give him to you for free.
Maybe I'll trade you clickbait for Kenny.
I don't want clickbait.
No, not clickbait. What's his name? Cyclops? Has he been bothering you too?
Oh, no. Actually, Cyclops is pretty cool. He never called into the show, actually. He calls into
he
yours.
Called me.
Halfway into my show, I'll be calling Gonzo Network and telling them that I want $10,000 advance.
What?
Don't bother.
That thing you told me to. That's a good idea.
Fuck you. Okay, Kenny. I don't know, dude. Do you have ADHD, ADD, or something?
No.
You're on the spectrum, bro. You have to be. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about sometimes.
You said to call them and while on the air and say
that was like 2 weeks ago, Kenny. I'm over it.
I'll do it.
Kenny, that was 2 weeks ago.
It's never happening. It's all bullshit. What do they do with the the payments, Shimmer?
What's a good bit to do on the air, calling them and asking them for what?
Oh,
I'll either ask for $10,000 advance or I'll tell them to go fuck themselves. Either
you know,
way,
Sans is smart. Maybe we shouldn't have any co-hosts. Look at what happens. Oh, my God. Kenny, is this how your show is going to be? Are we getting a taste of a little taste of what your show's
no,
like?
No, I'll keep him on track.
I'll have some trivia questions, and then I'll call those assholes right in the middle of the show.
Oh, no, I don't want you doing that. That's stupid.
Kenny, who's your co-host going to be?
Troy Smith.
Okay.
That but was your idea anyways, to call them during the show and ask for $10,000 advance.
Yeah, I don't want you to do that anymore. Let's keep them out of this. Just do your show, man.
Okay, then I'll call them off the air and tell them to go fuck themselves.
All right, do whatever you want to do.
No, do it on air.
You see, people want it on the air.
So all right, fine. That's up to you. That's not my decision. Okay, you do whatever you want. You call the shots. All right, it's your hour.
Okay, and I'll be in your studio.
Yeah, can you wear some provocative?
Yes, I'm going to set it up for you. Kenny, the webcam should have come today.
It did not. Then, therefore, it should come on Monday.
Yeah.
Hey, Kenny, do you live in a trailer? What is your... Do you live in a trailer or where the fuck you live?
I live in an apartment building.
It's an apartment? It's really tiny. Do you have a kitchen at all?
I have an alley kitchen. Most apartment buildings.
Can you can you give us a tour of your kitchen and your fridge and stuff?
I can't do that from the webcam.
Oh, God.
Can you do it with your phone right now?
McNastycast. So if you tune into McNastycast tomorrow at like
no thanks
2 o'clock in the morning or 1 a.m. I can do it then.
Yeah, I don't want to do it. That's all right.
Co-host Marissa Mendelson has been confirmed as a co-host tomorrow evening.
We have no idea what the fuck you're talking about.
I do McNastycast after show now, and she's agreed to be a co-host.
All right. Well, congratulations. It looks like your career is skyrocketing. Wow, what a guy. Screeching halt. What is this?
I don't know.
Oh, boy.
Kenny ignored my phone call and my text today.
Gives a fuck. You should be thanking him for ignoring you. Why would you want to talk to
me?
Why would you call him? Kitty, what the fuck are you thinking to call this guy?
He's ignoring me, Jimmer.
Just like that Elaine episode of Seinfeld where that guy forgot
he
who she was
and
it
sort of
turned on Elaine.
I called 20 minutes ago to check on him and he's denying that
okay,
I called.
I have a missed call. I'm sorry.
Wow.
The phone was in my jacket. I did not mean to ignore you.
Is this how Kenny sounds on a regular phone, like a regular phone conversation? Huh. What?
Yeah.
And you enjoy this shit?
Oh, Kitty.
Kitty, you're crazy. You're
this is true self.
Not only do you harass black people on the street.
I'm not harassing anyone. Jimmer.
You get yourself involved with Kenny on the phone and you call this. I mean, no disrespect to you, Kenny, but I mean, you're not lighting the world on fire with your phone conversation here.
I just sent her text back.
Our conversations are fine, Jimmer.
Okay, well,
I'm not
do whatever
totally
the fuck
you
want. All right, do whatever you want. Okay?
Not totally, but kind of.
All right, Kenny, do you have any more questions at all? Or can we hang up on you now? Or
I guess so. I guess I'll join Discord.
Oh, please. All right, thank you, Kenny.
Thanks for taking calls, as always. Talk to you
bye
later.
Bye for now. Fuck. It takes him forever to hang up, too. Hey, Saiyans. I don't want to keep you too long. I mean, you can jet whenever you want, brother. But you can hang out whenever, however long you need. So, because you're on East.
Let me finish my Anthony Cumia story before we were rudely interrupted.
By Kenny.
So it was a pretty legendary thing. Like I was saying, Anthony Cumia, notorious Guinea Republican gun, well, no longer owns guns. Exposed to have had sex with a tranny.
For real?
Yes, it started when his ex-girlfriend, a woman by the name of Melissa Stetton, went on her podcast and said she saw this weird tweet from a transsexual named Sue Lightning. And she figured out that Sue Lightning had been saying stuff about Anthony. Then Sue Lightning took a picture from inside the same bathroom the hotel he was in. And then there was a picture of Sue Lightning sitting on his couch holding one of his guns, his Desert Eagle. Once again, the Republican Guinea Wop Anthony, there's only one reason this could be, and he's tried to deny it all.
Wow. Shit. So, wait, Sue Lightning, is she like the... What is she, hot, or is she the ugly girl?
She looks like she's fucking 12, which was his main attraction.
Oh.
But, okay. And especially at the time, you know, she's now a video gamer.
Oh, let me look her up, actually. I don't know who she is, but Sue Lightning. Oh, okay. She has, like, oh, yeah. So she's a dude?
Yeah. I think she started as just a webcam thing and then moved into video games.
Here, let me show everybody. Well, oh, wow. Okay. She's a dude? Shit. Are you sure?
Positive.
Whoa.
This is the story related to us by Anthony's ex, Melissa Stetton. That's why Anthony will forever be known as Trampa or Tramptony.
Wow. No, I'm in the way here. That's a dude?
Yeah.
What's that kid baby screaming noise?
I think that's
my son is flipping out.
Oh, okay. Well, if you have to go, let us know, bro. But look at the Sue. This is Sue Lightning. You see the screen here with the big boobies? Is this her?
Does it have short black hair?
Yeah.
Yep, that's them. I don't know the whole pronouns. What is it? A sis or something?
Whoa. She doesn't look like a... Well, in here maybe, but... She looks like a chick. Oh, you're right. Okay, so it did say so Tranthony. So Tranthony will fuck Sue Lightning, but not Rihanna.
Oh, yes, because Anthony very racist.
There's a cock there.
And hates any other girl but white girls.
Wait, this girl does porn? I just saw some cock a little bit. Dildo. Yep. Okay. All right. Fuck it, man. Damn. So he denies that he fucked her?
Yes, and that, like, if you hit him with the some dude hit him with the, they were having some battle on Twitter, and a dude brought up Sue Lightning, and Anthony doxed him and actually called the guy his job and tried getting him fired.
Wow. Was this recent, or was this a little while ago?
Yeah, it was very recent. I tried getting the guy to do a calling because, you know, he was DMing with me on Twitter, and he was like, no, the fucking guy really, I guess he worked at some college. He was like, I got called into the dean's office and saying some guy is calling from the internet and you're saying anti-trans things.
Yeah. Wait, so Opie and Anthony hate each other, right?
Yes.
So does Opie bust Anthony's balls for fucking a tranny?
No, he should.
He just stays away from it?
Everyone, it all started out with everyone hating on Opie.
Yeah.
And everyone loved Anthony. Then Anthony started crumbling. Right now, Anthony's offering $5,000 to shut down Reddit. He's doxing people. This would be the perfect time for Opie to attack Anthony, hit him with all the tranny stuff, but he won't.
I wonder why. Is Opie like going PC? Or he's more PC.
He might just not have the talent. He just got a job at Westwood One to start doing a podcast there, but
I heard about that.
He probably won't bring it up. He keeps saying he's taking the higher road, even though all of them take shots at Opie.
Hey, I have a question about Westwood One, though. Is Tim Sabian some sort of, what is his role in Westwood One?
I think they just hired him to run it.
Does that guy watch your scopes, or does that guy watch your YouTube channel too? Because he watches my scopes. He's on Periscope, and he watches a lot of my shows.
I think I've seen him one time like one of my tweets. I just assume they all watch because they all know.
Because I was figuring he's kind of scouting out talent, Tim Sabian, for future podcasts. It's my take on that.
Well, basically, Opie only got the job there because Tim Sabian got hired, and he used to work with them with Howard Stern.
Yeah. Fuck, man. How long do you think?
He should smash back at Anthony. I don't get what the hesitation. Like, they're taking real shots and constant shots because, well. Like, right now, everyone hates Anthony on Reddit and shit. So, he'll usually go into the well. He'll trash Opie about something and try and get them all on his side. And Opie just takes it.
Does Anthony or Opie go into their own Reddit, Opie and Anthony Reddit, and actually...
Yes.
They do?
No, they don't post as themselves, but they read every single solitary thing in there.
But do they comment?
Well, under fake Reddit names. Like, it just came out that Anthony's brother, he exposed his fake Reddit name, and they went back like a year and found out he trashed his own brother, Anthony, like a year ago, when Anthony was supposed to go to rehab for the domestic violence thing.
I saw
his
that.
His brother was like, he'll just be right back out and start drinking again.
Damn, dude.
Which is what happened, so...
So Anthony's kind of like the bad boy because he has that domestic violence. I saw a YouTube video of that where his girlfriend or something called the cops or some shit. And then there's another thing about him with some black chick, some stripper that he was trying to take a picture of. And that's what got him fired, right? From fucking SiriusXM. Because he was tweeting fucking racial,
his claim
racist shit.
Is that he took a picture. She came up crazy, started hitting him, and then he went on Twitter and was like, that's why there's a problem, like saying shit about the black community. That's his version of the story, and since he's turned out to be an infamous liar about everything, I would take that version with a grain of salt. But, yeah, that's why he got fired.
And then so it just became the Opie show.
Yeah, Opie and then Radio. Opie got fired for recording some dude in the bathroom at SiriusXM.
Who, Howard?
No, Roland. But he had a problem with Howard, too, because they would walk around in the hallway and
Opie would
go, hello, Howard. So Howard made some policy at SiriusXM that the hallways have to be closed when he's walking around. And it was pretty much all because of Opie. Then Opie posted a video of, like, some maid letting him into the Howard Stern studios. And he got, like, a couple feet in and turned around. That was the whole thing.
Wonder why he did that shit. I mean, he was already in. If he just fucking behaved, he would have just stayed with Sirius and made money. I don't understand why he was busting Howard's balls. He knew that Howard's running that shit. They hate each other still? Doesn't he want to be Howard, or doesn't he want to, like, doesn't he talk well about him and shit?
It all goes back to the gag order. When Howard Stern put on a gag order, back when there was still, what was... K-Rock under officially, CBS or Clear Channel?
Clear Channel. Yeah.
How they both technically worked for Clear Channel, and Howard put a gag order saying they're not allowed to talk about him. And
and
even after they got fired, if they did, they would have been charged $100,000 every time they mentioned his name. That's why when they were originally fired for having a couple have sex in a church, they weren't out of work for, they weren't fired. They were just taken off the air. They were still getting paid. I think they both had a $10 million contract, but they couldn't work for 2.5 years.
So do you think Opie and Anthony or are they, do you think they're bigger, they have a bigger audience or following than Stern now currently?
Yes, because their shit's overseas now and Howard won't let his stuff go overseas.
So is Opie and Anthony bigger overseas than the States? Is that what you're saying? Like in the UK or wherever? If you go to
Reddit, a good 60% of it is British.
Oh, okay. So they're getting the old Opie and Anthony.
Like I said, Stern doesn't let his shit on YouTube. And, you know, Jim Norton is touring in Europe all the time because now he has a fan base there because people in Europe can't listen to SiriusXM. It's just strictly America and Canada.
Mm-hmm. What do you think
they no longer have a show, so
what do you think the listening audience is for Opie and Anthony now, like the fan base? Because I would assume safely that Howard probably has less, like about 100 to 150,000 like 100 to 150,000 solid listeners daily, somewhere around that number, maybe 100,000, 150. It's my guess. But what would Opie and Anthony?
Since they're not on, I made the argument, I believe, right before Anthony got fired, from probably 2012 to 2014 when Anthony got fired, because their shit was coinciding with the YouTube part too. They were probably, not counting the people listening at Sirius, probably had like 1 million people listening to him with all right. The YouTube shit going on.
You mean at OP Radio?
No, I mean just people uploading their show. Like the one person uploading their show was a British dude named Stephen Knight. The show just hit Europe. So
they're getting the old stuff.
That's what I'm saying. Jim Norton can go to fucking Ireland tomorrow and sell out a theater there because people in Ireland have listened to the Opie and Anthony show on YouTube.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. So, and then Jim Norton left Opie and then he's got a show with Sam Roberts. Right. Yeah. So
he sort of, you know,
they're doing okay though. Right. I mean, Sam Roberts and Jim,
their show's terrible.
It's terrible, but they get high caliber guests. I mean, it's pretty consistent. I mean, they're probably making some money, especially Jim Norton, probably. I don't know about Sam. Maybe Sam makes some too.
It's a
weird
situation. It's a show that was never meant to be a show. It's supposed to be a transitional show. But, I mean, and since YouTube just did, I mean, Sirius did this last crackdown on the channels that were posting them. I mean, yeah, they'll maybe get like 10,000, but they're not Opie and Anthony. That's the problem. It's like if they fired Howard and Robin and then did the Howard Stern show.
Yeah. And have like a fucking JD come in or some Jason.
I'm sure it wouldn't be the worst thing ever, but
John Hyde.
Not the fucking Howard Stern show.
Right. Or kind of like the wrap-up show, you know, like Baba Booey and fucking John Hine did it. They don't get the fucking audience that Howard gets, but they get some of it. A little bit.
Yeah, like Jim Norton was the third mic guy, and I guess you would consider Sam Roberts the fourth mic guy. So, like, the third mic guy and the fourth mic guy are now doing the show. I mean,
Jim Norton's not like... Though. Jim Norton's like... He's supposed to be the main guy, right? He's supposed to be the actual... The lead, right, for this, whatever they're doing on Sirius, their show. And I don't know if does he fit well in that role?
No, because people have given him shit. They're like, Sam Roberts, he's the nerd guy, started out in radio. He shows up early. He does prep for the show. Jimmy walks in as soon as the show starts at 8:05. He's probably late every day. And we just don't know it because it's radio. So.
Yeah. But
people have called out Jim, and Jim's answer is, this is the way I've always performed. And no one's ever said, well, yeah, you always stirred Mike. Didn't matter. There were two main co-hosts.
Please come again.
You're the main guy.
Way better than Cyan's shit show.
Jimmer and Saint. No, it says not bad. They're saying not bad, you two. They like us, Jimmer and Saiyans together. But tell them the fuck off.
Shot at a nigga.
Yeah, it was only a dollar. yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, I remember Sam Roberts was popular because of he was into wrestling and shit. And I'm into WWE. And I know him from those, like, he would interview wrestlers and shit. That's what he was doing before this Jim and Sam Roberts show, I think. Right? I mean, he's into wrestling.
That's his niche. And, like, they're more passionate about. Sam cares way more. Well, he cares about the radio thing, too. Jim couldn't care less. He's just happy he's paid there. But like I said, his excuse is that's the way I've always performed, but he's never been the main guy. And he is the main guy. I mean, they like to consider themselves equals, but Jim's name is first, and Jim gets paid way more money than Sam does.
Yeah. I mean, I've watched a few clips of that show, Jim and Sam, and Jim Norton just doesn't, the flow is not there as far as like him being the main dude. Like it just doesn't work. I feel like he's not like the main broadcast. Like he can't carry the show very well. Like it's almost awkward.
They desperately need a third mic in there. Anthony was great when he went on, but now Anthony's banned from the show out of nowhere. Who knows why? So they need to hire a third, because not only that, Jimmy also takes off time. Like he misses at least a day a week, so it's just Sam by himself.
That's boring.
Yeah, and like I could shit on Sam, but his name's not first, and he's not getting paid the most money. So it'd be like me complaining that Stern left and Robbins left doing a fucking show. I can't really complain because the main guy's not there.
Right. And what's up with this? Have you heard the rumors of XFL? So the XFL is supposed to come back in 2020 or some shit. And then are they going to hire Opie and maybe Sam Roberts?
Opie's lying. What about Sam? Reached out to Opie.
I heard Sam Roberts might be a voice of the XFL. I'm not sure, but I heard Opie, and I mean, that was the rumors. Opie Sam.
Opie put that out. No, they didn't. They didn't reach out to Opie. Sam, maybe, because he has a relationship with them. He's in radio. He does a wrestling podcast. That would make sense. Probably Sam Roberts.
And he would probably, yeah, he'd bring like some legitimacy, I guess, because he's more of a kind of clean cut kid, like a clean cut broadcaster. He's not like edgy or anything, you know. He doesn't do anything really edgy. I mean, he's pretty
annoying.
He is. I don't find him funny at all. I don't know why people like him, I guess. I don't know. Do they? Who knows? No, we have a call. Really. Okay, 817.
What's up, Jimmy?
What's up, Michael? What's up, Michael?
Hey, yeah, Sam works for WWE, so.
Yeah, I know. We know. You like him?
Did you hear the interview with about the XFL?
No. No. With Vince McMahon.
There will be no WWE talent. Well, it's not going to be like the old XFL. WWE talent will not be involved in no way, shape, or form.
Yeah, because when they first launched the XFL, it was pretty fucking dumb and goofy.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys remember, they're using like fucking chicks, like, I don't know, it was like all scripted
one time because they didn't fill it up or some shit.
Yeah, it just didn't work. XFL, fuck that. I don't know if it's gonna work now, but we'll see what happens.
The guy that did the XFL with Vince is doing his own football league.
Who's doing?
I forgot his name, but he started his in 2019.
Yeah. Yeah, somebody said something about the lingerie football. Remember the fucking, who was in there? Angie Everhart, she was in like a lingerie bowl or some shit. I like that.
I don't know.
It was like a pay-per-view event way back in the day when Oh, I would watch that again. Fuck the XFL. Don't NFL.
Lingerie football?
What was that?
Do they still do that?
I don't think so. Nah. It was just like for like 2 years or three, and then it was done. So. Hey, Michael, do you have a question for Saiyans? Are you subscribed to him or?
No, I never watched the show before.
Oh, okay.
You motherfucker.
Michael, you got to go check him out. You were in his channel the other night when we all went in there. So go subscribe.
Well, I'll take you off, Saiyans.
Yeah, for sure, brother. He's good.
What's he talk about? Same thing you talk about?
Yeah, I think you're going to like him because I think, yeah. Because, like, we have, like, a lot of mixed, like, a lot of people that watch him watch me and vice versa. It's like we share, you know, a few same viewers. So
and literally vice versa. I think he's in the chat right now.
Oh, vice versa. Yeah. And then there's high number in here. I don't really see high number, but I see him in yours.
Where are you from, fans?
Rhode Island.
Oh.
Yeah. Aren't you originally from New York, though?
No.
No? Okay. I thought you were, like, from Brooklyn or something.
The fans are Bulls fans.
What was that?
The Saiyans are Bulls fans.
The Saiyans are Bulls fans. What's that?
Bulls. Chicago Bulls fan.
Oh, Chicago Bulls fan.
No.
Oh, you're not? I thought you were. Are you from Chicago?
I lived there for like a year when I was in the Navy, but no. But when black people wear sports team stuff, it has nothing to do with support of the team.
I know.
What is it for? Like
it's purely aesthetic.
Oh, it's
trust me.
Yeah.
I have more black friends than I do have white friends. I know.
And you don't like any basketball teams, right, Michael? You just like LeBron James, like certain basketball players. You don't like you don't have like a favorite basketball team, right? You said that before. Me? Yeah, you just said you like certain players, like LeBron James.
Yeah, I go wherever LeBron goes.
Yeah, so he's coming to L.A. this year, this summer. So you're gonna be
he's
a Lakers
not going
fan.
To Lakers, by the way.
Yes, he is. Shut up. Now you got to leave. How dare you? Of course he's going to be on the Lakers.
He's going to be on the, he's going to go back to Miami.
No. We will not allow that to happen. All right, Michael. Well, do you have any other questions or for Saiyans?
No.
All right, brother. Well, thanks for calling, bro.
I'll go subscribe to your channel.
Oh, by the way, Saiyans, Michael actually won the... We had a contest yesterday, and we're giving away two free cam shows. One for Tara, 15 minutes free. Well, it's not free. One of our viewers paid for it, $75 or whatever what the cost is. And then Jessica Jade as well. So Michael Sachs won a Jessica Jade show, and then Troy Smith won a... Tara's bum show. I was going to try to call you, but you're off air. So you lost out, brother. You could have got Tara's bum. Saiyans.
Yeah,
well, you had 15 minutes. Yeah, the 15 minutes, dude. On us. But you ended your stream, and I couldn't get in contact with you. So I was going to put you on, but, you know, on the list. But Michael Sachs won.
Hey, for my cam show, make a sandwich.
Really?
Oh, yeah, I want to make her do weird stuff. Like, just nonsense.
You wouldn't want to see her butt? Her butthole?
Like, hey, vacuum. Do something.
Dude, did you see Tara twerk? All right, thanks, Michael. Yes. What's up, Tara? What's up, Michael?
I got to say one thing before I go. Fuck Gonzo. Bye.
Thank you. F Gonzo. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Do you, so your show is basically, do you have any guests on most of the time? Is it hard to book guests? I find it sometimes difficult, but is that your format or do you just kind of interact with the dudes and chicks in there?
I would take a guest, but A lot of them don't want to do it. I mean, people find me a bit contentious for some reason. I don't know what it is. But
they're afraid to come on.
Yeah, if you want, like, I try getting Opie and Anthony's former. It'd be like if Baba Booey got fired and came back. He's come back, Danny Ross, and started leveling accusations against everyone who he worked for, and serious ones against Anthony. And I was trying to get him, but he's decided to do some weird Patreon thing.
Yeah, I saw your video.
Charge people to do his show. So far, he's got 3 patrons for $10, and his goal is to get 500 patrons, not even $500.
$500? Oh, he wants 500 patrons. Oh my God! It should be the other way around. He should ask for money, like a money goal.
I said the exact same thing in my video. That makes no sense.
Because everyone could give a dollar, you know, and that's $500. What are you gonna do with the podcast for $500? He's not gonna do it.
He's trying to like not talk about the trashing stuff. You know, the interesting shit. He wants to talk about The Walking Dead, which I said is fine. But start a fucking YouTube channel. No one's paying you to hear you talk about The Walking Dead.
Oh, he's gonna charge the fuck. No way, dude.
And if you buy it, like, yeah, you know how you have the different tiers. If you get the most expensive tier, then you can ask him an Opie and Anthony question. But since he doesn't do the shows live, because, you know, he overproduces them, so every time he talks, he changes the audio and shit. So you'll never know even if your shit's going to make it in the thing he ends up talking about.
Oh, that is pretty lame. Wow. Yeah, I guess he's not going to be doing a podcast then, because that's not going to work.
Yeah. And I told him, dude, because I was trying to get him calling to me. He was like, now, like, you know, you would probably... I doubt you could go on the fucking Jim and Sam show. You're not going to hit your goal, but you get more interest if you talk to me, but you don't want to.
So what's your fucking end goal, man, in all this? Like, what is the ideal situation for you? Because I know you're a YouTuber like me, but like, what would you want to happen from all this shit? Like,
for YouTube to just leave me alone. That's my end goal. I have to worry about the strikes. And if I never got my channel taken down, shit was going gravy.
But if like SiriusXM or like a podcast like Westwood One or anybody like if they approached you, is that the end goal? Would you consider going and doing that format or doing regular radio if that even became an option? Like, is that something that you would consider? Like, what's the end goal there? Like, I don't know.
It would all depend on the situation, because like every place you just named is in New York, and you'd have to pay me a shitload of fucking money to A, live in New York, or B, like, say I got once a week thing to get my ass up there and back. So
yeah,
we'd be talking some serious scratch. I don't know. I don't really have an end goal. I like to just do what I do.
Hey, do you want to take a prank call? This is probably Ian Ellis, or do you want to take this or no?
Sure.
All right, let's see what happens. All right, go ahead. You probably know who this is, but go ahead.
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Yeah, can you hear?
Perfectly.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, you sound really low.
Okay, well then, should I hang up on you then?
All right. Yeah.
All right, bye. Fuck. Stupid ass. So you'd be good with doing YouTube for the long term, or streaming and shit like that, your own sort of format, podcast or video webcasting? Is that kind of like you're doing your own thing? Because you do get a lot of power just doing it by yourself, because you don't like fucking have to. I guess if you work for Sirius or someone, you kind of have a boss, I guess. I don't know.
Like, don't get me wrong, I would appreciate the convenience of it, of just showing up and doing it and not have to do all the other shit, you know, stream like other people doing that shit. Like, I get the convenience of it, but
yeah,
don't know. Like I said, it would depend if anything was offered, what the offer would be.
Yeah, I guess I'm in the same boat. It just depends. And I would you want to be like tied down to like, okay, if Sirius says, oh, you can't say this, you can't do that, you can't do this, you have to be really clean. You know, would you, if they paid you enough money, would you just follow and just say, okay, I'm okay with that then. I won't be myself. Or like, how would you handle that situation?
It depends what the money would be. And like, it all depends on the situation. Like I could talk about, like, if you really put the thing in perspective, all right, they offered Sane to show. I could talk about whatever. I could babble about movies. I could. So if they said, don't talk about Anthony, I could not do it. And if they're willing to pay me to not do it, I guess I wouldn't care if I was being paid to.
What if they say you have to go PC? Care. What if they say you got to be PC? You know, you can't say the N word. You can't say fag or nigger or, you know, whatever. You can't say these words. You got to be PC.
Oh, the best words ever made, by the way.
Yeah, but let's say they say, we'll hire you, but you can't say these words because in society today, it's just not acceptable. And you can't talk politics. You can't do any of that shit. I mean, would you be okay with that if the money was good?
Honestly, probably.
Yeah.
Because you know what I would consider it like? I consider it like an acting job. You know,
right.
If you got a show, like let's switch it from radio, and someone to hire you to be on a sitcom. Well, you couldn't say bad words or swear there, but I just consider it like an acting job. Like I said, I could talk about anything. If they're paying you money, shit, I can sit there and just babble about the Patriots for 2 hours. Doesn't matter.
Right. Yeah, I mean. But
that's a pie in the sky, not my vision. So now I just talk about what I like to talk about.
Yeah.
And I love it. Like if I'll talk about Dragon Ball Z and everyone will start complaining, I'll be like, the name of the channel is Sane's Entertainment, you motherfuckers. I'm allowed to talk about what I want. If I wanted to just talk about one thing, my name would be based on that one thing.
Please come again.
Science, bring me onto the Jim Erenham show. I could give two shits about Opie and Anthony.
Titties? Who's titties? Hey, Kitty, are you still here? Billiam? They checked out. What are you guys? Are you guys here or not? Oh, I don't know if they're here. But, fuck, man. Yeah, I don't know. Me too. I guess I'm like the same. It depend on the offer because I live in fucking California. Shit, man, you're gonna have to pay me something to go out there in New York to live in New York. Well,
they got studios out there in California and shit.
Sirius X? Oh, okay. Well, maybe. I don't know where Westwood One is. Is that in fucking East Coast?
They got. I think yeah, but they probably got places all over.
Dude, what if Compound Media asked you? Hey, maybe we'll do something.
They literally couldn't afford me.
Fuck, man, those guys. Do they hire people and shit? Like other fucking people for their network or whatever you call it?
Do they what?
Do they hire? Are they hiring people too? Do they hire other shows besides Anthony Cumia?
They got a bunch of shows. They make like no money. They're all people who live in New York. I mean, their shows don't do anything. Nobody watches them. They're not getting paid money. Kevin Brennan basically admitted he gets paid like $200. They're all once a week shows and they only get paid like $200 to do it.
Oh, 516, you're on.
Man, so you guys gonna do like a team up now? It's like a Super Friends thing.
Okay, so hi Ian. This must be Ian Ellis. Hey, why don't you turn off the shit on the back in the background? We can have a conversation. You can talk to Saiyans if you want.
On the thing together, and now you're taking this as a fence.
What?
Asked you to be doing a team up. It's a pertinent freaking question, and you're saying I'm somebody else that I'm not. I mean, what the fuck is wrong with you, dude?
All right, so who are you then, Mr. Hotshot?
one of your 69 viewers watching you, and I asked a pertinent question. Are you going to do a team up on a regular basis? Why don't you answer the 69.
Question? 69.
69. 71, bitch. Get the number correct.
Okay, whatever. You're so... Hey, Kyle, are you going to do a team up?
What?
Sure.
Yeah, we're doing one right now.
Regular basis with this guy. He obviously doesn't want to answer the question, so I asked Kyle. Are you going to do a team up on the regular basis with him?
All right, damn, Mr. fucking district attorney. What the fuck is this
thing is up? Why? Oh, so you could jerk off?
He evades stuff, so his crew left him, so you're here by yourselves. So
they're here.
And people seem to be enjoying it. Yeah. And I'm asking if you're going to do a team up. He doesn't want to answer the question, so I ask you.
He answered your fucking question, you idiot. You're such an idiot. He already answered your question.
Sure. I guess you're looking at it, nigga. What the fuck?
He probably wants
on a regular basis.
This guy wants to jerk off to both of us.
On a regular basis.
He wants to jerk off to both our voices.
And he'd have a regular fucking question. All of a sudden, he's like, "Oh, you're Ian Ellis." No,
then who are you?
He's like has PTSD from being fucked with all the time.
Oh, okay.
Can he handle hanging with Kyle on the regular?
Dude, he fucking answered your question. So, what's your next question, you shithead?
Boy, you're kind of an angry little guy. You fucking get your colonel pin pills.
Okay.
Oh shit.
You got me. He hung up. Is that Ian Ellis? I recognize the voice.
Bitch Hedberg?
Is that really him? Who is this guy? The guy sounds like the guy that goes on that shitty the Matthews. Is his name Matthew or whatever?
Broke Bar, Bitch Hedberg, and Bitch Hedberg's manager.
They have a whopping 8 viewers right now, by the way.
My God.
Yeah.
This is
barely hanging
this is
on.
Record, Jim Renan.
Well, yeah. I mean, and then two of them are what? The Unbleached guy. He's in there. So that's one. And then his friend Ian Ellis or whoever the fuck. Who's the guy he speaks to? Do you know that guy?
Who knows? Who cares? Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
If you were years into doing this and right now you had 8 people watching, would you bother to do this?
No, I didn't. If during the day when I do like my YouTube videos and I record live, so I actually don't have the chat going, but I see my numbers and I have like 12, and that depresses me. But I know people are at work, you know. But I'm doing a YouTube chat. Yeah. I'm doing a YouTube video, so it doesn't matter at the time. So people will watch the replay. But the shows, if I'm doing a show. Fuck, if I had 8 viewers or less than 20 or even less, I don't know. I would be, I'm out, dude. I mean, what are you, you're wasting your time.
Dude, no? The other day I was at my friend's house and we did a test stream because I was trying to work out my chat bot. It's a 17-minute video with no audio. There's no, it's just us testing out the chat bot. 17 minutes long. It has more views than Broke Bar's 12-hour stream.
Oh, my God.
I couldn't imagine doing this for nothing. Not even for nothing. Not even for money, but no one's watching you. And then they fall in the same boat because they've all spent money on doing this.
Oh.
I just got a laptop. And I begrudgingly did it.
Yeah. So he doesn't understand. He doesn't understand that it's about like people being interested in what you're saying, you know, like the content. It's not about the quality shit, you know. You could have the best quality, but if people aren't watching, then what's the point? And his quality shit, by the way.
Sit around babbling about nothing and people, that's what these people think. That they literally think he really thinks he worked in radio. Just because he started a site with radio in the name. He legitimately thinks, like right radio. Now, what he's doing isn't a show. He's got 8 people watching.
And 2 of them are, well, one of them's him and the other one's his buddy. That he.
Yes.
So there's 6 people, actually. 5 or 6. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's like, but they're trying. They can claim for the end the time we're not really. You're in a fucking studio, dude.
You're trying and you failed. And it's sad. You're selling clothes to make rent. And then his retort is, yeah, I paid my rent this month. What are you going to do next month? There goes that computer you got, your camera, dude. Sad. I can't imagine doing this. It's like at the end of the day, this shit is capitalism. You put your product out there years ago and it failed.
Yeah.
If you had shareholders, they would have fucking, you would have been bankrupted by now for not bringing in 1 cent.
And
get it.
I don't get it either. And to say that he's actually doing this for fun, he says, oh, I'm doing this for fun. It's all fun. No, it's not. It's not fucking fun. You sitting in front of a camera and these hot lights or whatever. It's not fun. It's work, you know? Like, we're sitting here working, you know?
I played a clip. I think you've seen it during a drunk live stream. I hit broke far with, instead of doing this, maybe where, you know, no one's watching you, maybe you should go out and get a girlfriend. His response was, well, I'm going to go meet a girl and she'll suck up all my creativity. It was one of the most cringiest things I've ever heard in my life. It was just like, dude, you have no one. What creativity to get two people watching you? This is delusional thinking on these people's brains, and it's whatever, but sad.
Yeah. But it's not that we, I'm sure you enjoy it. I enjoy what I do, but sometimes it's tough to get on camera and work, you know? Like, it's like, you know, it's not like, because we're doing it so, we do it every day. You know, you do it every day, I do it every day, whether we're recording videos or we're streaming live, we're doing it every day, you know? Like, a lot of YouTubers don't do what we do. We work really hard, you know? Like, they don't put out content every day like we do. Like 3 or 4 videos. They do maybe one every other day or maybe once a week. You know, they don't do what we do. They can't sit on here and do live streams and actually like hold an audience. We've been having like almost 70 people in here this entire time, you know, like just holding an audience. I mean, we could probably go for another 10 hours or 24 hours. People would still be in here. It's.
Yeah. It's because these guys, they have nothing to talk. They don't. He has, like, I'll bring a broke bar. He has no life to talk about. He lives with his mom. He's never had pussy. He just got fired from McDonald's. What life experience does he possibly have to talk about? He's not funny. He thinks, I'll sit in my shit studio I made and watch videos of some other person nobody knows about and just say, music stinks. Movies suck. Netflix isn't good. And it's just like, I'm looking at someone with no life experience who's not funny, but isn't self-aware enough to realize it didn't happen. You would think 2 years in when you posted a video and got 20 views, it would have dawned on you, oh, this didn't work. But like I said, He went on Reddit trying to meet chicks and he worked in radio. Maybe he sees this as his in and he has to lie. Like first, Tef Pattern, he said, me and Tef Pattern used to do videos together. I asked Tef Pattern, he goes, no, we didn't. Then before he started attacking you, he said, me and Jimmernam are going to start doing a show together. I'm like, Jimmernam wouldn't do a show with you. What are you talking about?
Show. Oh my God, dude. The guy's delusional. And, I don't know what to tell him. I would give him some advice on how to be a little bit more successful. Well, why should I help him? He's a jerk off. And I don't know. He brought this upon himself. What a loser.
I don't think he realizes that people like me and you, we've seen people like him before.
Yeah.
You think we haven't battled? And here's the most fucked up thing. If our shit gets taken down, we'll be back tomorrow.
Yeah, because of our audience. They're really fucking loyal.
Now, please, the thing he again. Better hope is now he's almost in a catch 22.
You really piss me off.
Let's say he ever did catch some subs off of the beef. As you know and I know, the second you get any numbers, your shit's getting shut down.
Yeah.
Will you be able to come back? Shut down my channel tomorrow. I have another 1,000 subs by next week. I have 1,000 people that will just subscribe to me.
And then you got to be able to hold the audience. So if he stole, like, let's say 20 people from us, which he... Oh, well, let's get this call. You got to be able to retain the audience the entire time you're doing a show, basically. But 312, you're on.
Hey, Jimmer, it's Mark Lista.
Oh, what's up, Mark? It's been a while.
Yeah. A bunch of people in the chat. You got to call in. Sainz is on. You know, Sainz is my other guy. He's really something. Sainz, you there? Can you hear me?
Yeah. Hey, Mark, can you talk with Sainz? I'm going to be right back. I got to
go ahead,
do
Jimmer.
Some
go
pee
ahead,
shit.
I gotcha.
All right.
Hey, Jimmer, Sainz,
what's
called
up, buddy?
Me. What's up?
Not much. Hey, I guess Jimmer had to take a break or something. But anyway, yeah, I just wanted to call in because there's like, you know, there's probably 80 people out there right now. Sainz is a guy. Everybody here in this community should support. He's been getting deleted off YouTube. He's sort of the epitome of what goes on. And, you know, eventually Jimmer will be in a position where the Howard Stern show is dead. But there's an avid bunch of supporters, and that's what Sainz's done. He's brought a bunch of really rabid people together. They're crazy. They're animals. And Sainz goes balls out every night. What's your channel name now?
Sainz Entertainment.
Sainz Entertainment. Because I know it was Sainz Rage for a while. So if you're subscribed to Sainz Rage, you got to...
I'm just going
to
put it Sainz Entertainment the rest of the time.
Now, here's the other thing I wanted to ask you. Are you taking... just Patreon now, or can you take Streamlabs? What's the deal with that?
Yeah, I'm taking Streamlabs. I gotta wait till the channel's monetized, but I don't know if you heard me and Jim and Em earlier with their fucking pending process. I'll hit the goal, the 4,000 watch hours by tomorrow, but so I don't know if I can do super, you know, the dollar sign in the super chat, but Streamlabs okay. And Patreon.
Streamlabs and Patreon. Okay, yeah, because when you hop off, you definitely got to put that link up in the chat, or if you can do it now, do it. And, folks, this is a guy we need to support. He's really gone after this Unbleached group. Oh, Sainz, wait till you hear this. So they made a T-shirt over there. Casey hit me up on Twitter, and there's a T-shirt. It says Mark Lista's tits, and they found a fat set of guy tits. You on the back pissing in a bucket. They made a T-shirt of you and I.
I've reached it's weird reaching this level to where now you have spinoffs of yourself.
That was my first thought. Well, here's my first thought. My first thought is they're our biggest fans.
Yeah.
You don't have a bigger fan than somebody who goes out of their way to make a T-shirt. Okay. Number one. Number two. Yeah. How ridiculous is a spinoff of a spinoff?
Exactly. It's like I said, when everyone, because trust me, they're not the first, nor will they be the last. But I just find it fascinating and hilarious, to be honest.
It is. It's incredible. I've played professional hockey. I've worked for 20 years. Nobody's ever made a T-shirt of me until Bitch Hedberg came along.
There's literally a T-shirt of me. Shouldn't I get a free one? Yeah. The fuck?
It's unbelievable. So I guess if you can't make content, you become a fanboy. They've successfully done that. And now they've launched a product line featuring us.
Of course. Dude, their whole channel is me. It's me. I'm in the title and it's my video, the whole channel. It's me.
That's what happened when you were trying to explain the beef, because I've seen it from both sides. See, first they came after you got smashed, right?
Yeah.
Whatever viewers they poached, they couldn't hold. Then they came after Jimmernam. Well, they came after Jimmernam on a night I was on. So I was ready for Ian Ellis, because he could have caught Jimmer with his head down. He might have caught ASMR stuttering and mumbling. William's gay. You can easily get William. And he's Jewish. He eats bagels, so his nose fits in that little hole. Otherwise, he wouldn't be able to eat it all. And I was ready for Ian Ellis. So when he came on, I put him on the bus out of Chicago. He got smashed. Now he made a T-shirt commemorating that night. So I kind of feel honored.
Should be honored.
I don't know why they're not calling in right now.
We have merchandise.
You know, I can we never make merch. Merchandise or Akira Toriyama would sue the shit out of me.
I feel like Rich Voss. I got merch. So listen. I got the respect of my peers, and I got merch. So anyway, I just wanted to give a shout out to everybody in the chat. Check out Sane's Entertainment. He's a guy we really need to support. He slammed Bitch Hedberg and the other fool, broke bar around long before these willows popped up in our pond. So yeah, support this guy. Check him out. Jimmer, are you back?
Yeah, I'm right here, brother.
Jimmer's not back yet.
I'm here.
He just said yeah.
Oh, maybe.
Oh, I can't hear him. All right, guys, I'll let you continue your chat. Peace out. Take care, everybody, and I'll talk to you later, all right?
All right, Mark. Mark's got his phone all fucked up, dude. That echo shit, man. But,
yeah.
Hey, we welcome these fuckers to call if they want to talk, but they're such pussies. They won't even say their names.
They're not going to call with me on the phone.
Yeah, they're big pussies.
Like I said, I got them to stop calling me because I go in, dude, and I think people look at me and they look at my videos and think they can take me on. When you get me and it's just me and you on the phone, oh, I can give a smashing.
Yeah, I feel like that E. I don't even know why we talk about this guy, Ian Ellis. Have you seen his comedy stand-up? It sucks. It's just horrible. I didn't laugh at one thing.
The way I destroyed Ian is I got this thing where I can just pick up on something about you. And I picked up on him that he sounds like and is doing the same act as Mitch Hedberg. So that's why he's called Bitch Hedberg. And it drives him fucking insane when I say it. Because I'm basically saying he's a comedian who's stealing a dead comedian's act, which he is, and it fucking infuriates him, which is why he doesn't really call in that much anymore.
Dude, but Mitch Hedberg
call in. He's nice.
Mitch Hedberg is a fucking genius. He's funny as fuck. This guy is not even in that fucking class. I mean, this guy sucks. I wouldn't even watch him for free. Like if he had a show for free, I wouldn't even go. Why would I wait? Even if they gave me free, if they gave me free alcohol, maybe, you know, but I wouldn't enjoy it. Would you fucking pay for a show to go watch this piece of shit? No. Wherever he's at.
Yeah. Well, that's why you don't pay them the respect of calling them by their actual names. You call them by the name you give them.
Bitch Hedberg.
And that's why Broke Bar is Broke Bar. Because that infuriates him because he knows it's true that he ripped off Red Bar's thing and just did it in reverse.
Yeah. Honestly, his studio sucks or whatever it is. It's fucking... I could build that shit very easily. It's so ugly. Oh, my God. With this stupid TV.
It's terrible. It sucks.
Yeah. And his stupid little soundboard that he uses to control the volume of his callers when they're bashing him. When I called in that night, I was fucking around with him. I was just talking over him, but I saw part of his replay, and what he does is he turns it down because I was talking about his daddy and me being his daddy because his daddy wasn't there for him and all this shit. Talking about his brother, how he put his brother to shame.
Well, you have to understand, Broke Bar is very upset because back before, he used to smoke weed. When he did a stream,
I saw that.
He's poor now, has no more money. He can't afford weed.
Yeah, he used to roll it up and, you know, he would take every single bit of weed off his table with like his little finger. Like he would stab at it to make sure he gets every single. Like this guy's a cheap ass motherfucker, you know? Like he would make sure.
Like the dude had to sell clothes to pay his mom rent. He can't smoke weed anymore. Soon he's going to be sucking dick for a donut. Like, it's sad, dude. And like I told him, why are you streaming and not filling out applications at like Burger King or something, dude?
Seriously. And he's 27 years old. Like, what is he going to do with the rest of his life? You know, he still has a few decades left in him, I would assume. And I don't know. Fuck, man. Probably no one's going to hire him. He's such a fucking dummy. Like, what is he going to do? Burger King ain't going to hire him.
He could never let them know he does anything on the internet because he says racist things. So,
oh, yeah.
That'd be done for him.
Did he say a lot of racist things against black people? Yeah.
And the craziest thing is he's a Uyghur.
So, really?
Yeah, of course he is.
Oh, man. I think he gives Uyghurs a bad name, to be honest with you. It's not even a Uyghur. It's a loser. It's a fucking loser, dude.
Sad.
Yeah,
I mean, I think I'm going to get out of here. I've been on the phone for a minute, nigga.
Hey, dude, I appreciate you coming and hanging out, bro. It was fun. And,
next time we do it, I got to go to the computer and do it next time. It'll be easier.
Yeah.
We're just standing and walking around.
Well, you sound awesome right now. I mean, your audio is great. But, yeah, man, thanks for hanging, and we'll chill again. But everybody go check out Sans Entertainment and go support him and go subscribe to him. And because we share pretty much all the same view. If you like what I do here, you're going to like what he does over there. So we're all good. All right, bro. You have a good one.
Thanks.
All right, peace.
Can't find it. Oh,
man, love that. All right, thanks, Sans. Peace, bro. Peace and love. So Sans joined us, and he's going to be leaving the call here. Let's see. There we go. ASMR, anybody here? Kitty? Billiam? Did y'all fall asleep, or what's going on? What are we doing? I have the phone lines up if you want to talk, and I actually had to... There's this fucking bug... That was bugging on the floor here. So I had to use my thing to smash it. The pincher bug. It was one of those pinchers, if you could see here. I don't know if you guys could see that. Probably not, but you get the point here. That was a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun there. I think we could do a great show together, huh? That was a first time we've actually... did something like this. So he called in a couple times before way back when we had a shitty Google Hangouts thing, but it sounded great on Discord, and we'll have to do it again. I'll probably hop over there if he, you know, has time for me to go over and say hi to him on that end, but on his channel. So make sure you go subscribe over there. Go to Eat the Bug. I ain't eating shit, man. Go subscribe to his channel. Just Sans Entertainment. Here, let me pull it up, actually.